Okay, so we are discussing about the functional decomposition and then trying to understand what are the functions needed in a product to get its final outcome or the main function of the product. So we discussed about two methods. We just briefly mentioned about the first method, which is known as the SOP, which is subtract and operate procedure, and this is used for products which are existing, and then by removing the components you will be able to get the functions identified. That is basically known as the subtract and operate procedure. So another important method is known as FAST, which we call it as the function analysis and system technique. It is used to define, analyze and understand product functions and how the functions relate to one another. The whole purpose of doing this functional decomposition is to look at what is the main function of the product and how can we get the main function through many small sub functions. So that is the need to do a functional decomposition. And we saw that any product, you can consider something is going as an input, and then you can say something comes out and as output. So this is basically the function. So whatever is inside is known as the function of the product. And if you want to get this main function, you need to have many small functions, then only you will be able to get the main function. So how to identify these small functions is basically the functional decomposition of a product. And I briefly mentioned about what is the FAST method and how do we do this. So basically what we do is we look at the products. Okay, I cannot remove. So basically what we do, we'll try to find out, we'll try to draw two lines and identify or ask questions, how is it done or why is it done. So that is what actually we do. How is it happening or why is it done? And we have a main function which is written here, and we have some assumptions that is given written on the right side. On the right side we write what is the input, so it's electrical energy. And on the left side, we write what is the output of this, that is air circulation for a fan. Now, we will try to find out how this electricity is converted to air circulation and what are the functions needed in the product between these two lines in order to convert this electrical energy to air circulation. And so, we will try to ask the questions, how air circulation is obtained. That is the first thing to ask. How is air circulation obtained? So we'll get the answer that okay, you have to rotate the blades in order to get the air circulation. So then ask the question, how rotation of blade is obtained? Then we'll say we provide torque to the blades. And how do you provide torque? Probably we convert electrical energy to rotational energy. So we'll get torque. And how do we convert? You provide electricity, then we can use something to convert that one. So that is basically the critical functions of the product, or we call this as the critical path functions. So this is known as critical path function. And then in order to get each one of these critical path function, we will have many sub functions, because somebody has to hold the blade, someone has to provide its degree of freedom, one directional degree of freedom. So these are becomes the sub functions coming here. Then provide torque. When you provide torque, you need to have a transmission of torque. You need to have, you will be having vibrations. Then you need to reduce the vibration, so that we call it as unwanted functions. And then provide some functions to reduce these vibrations. So like this, you will be able to get all the functions in a product using this method. And that is known as the FAST or functional analysis system technique. And this is one of the very common methods used for functional decomposition. Now let us take okay, so this can be, this is summarized here. So you'll be having the assumed function, which is the input function, and here the higher order function, which is the output, and all other functions which are actually coming out of this, between these two, is known as a critical path function. And this is by asking the question how, or you ask from the right side why, you will be able to get these functions. So that is how we get the critical path function. And all the functions that happen at the same time of these basic functions are known as the sub-functions. Okay. This is the caused by critical path function. So, these are the functions which are caused by critical path functions. Unwanted functions are the one which actually result because of this, for example, vibration, heating, these are all known as unwanted functions. So, you may get some vibrations or you may get some heating up of some of the elements. So, these are known as unwanted functions. So, in order to reduce the unwanted function, we may add some other functions here like reduce vibration, control temperature or provide cooling. So, these are known as the functions which will come as an outcome of unwanted function. And then all time functions are something like safety. One time function is something like transportation requirement or any other user training. All those things are known as one time functions. And project objectives are every design there will be some objective like reduce cost or reduce increase comfort. But these are the project objectives which may lead to some other additional function. So, this is how you get the FAST or the function analysis system technique based functional decomposition. So, we call this as the functional decomposition. Okay. So, compared to SOP, the difference is that this can be used for any new products. Okay. So, not only for existing products, so FAST can be used for any new product. As long as you know what is the input they are giving and what is the output that you are getting, you will be able to find out the critical path function. Okay. All right. So, let us take an example. And then we'll see how to do. I mean, how it is being done. For example, you take the case of a mixie or a grinder, but whichever it is, electrical mixie. It's a wet mixie or a dry grinder or a wet grinder. You can use this. So what we do? We first draw two lines, two dotted lines, which says, okay, this is anything within these two lines. These two lines is basically the functions of the product. Or the decomposed functions of the products. And then we say that we have a requirement that the product should have reduced noise. So, that is basically known as the project objective. Okay. So, there are existing mixes. So, you want to have a mixie which actually has got very less sound. That is the project objective. Yes. And the one time objective is that it should be compact. Because of transportation requirement, it should be compact, and all time requirement is aesthetic design. It should be very appealing to the user. So, these are the objectives, one time function and all time function. Now, we have this provide electricity is the assumption. So, that we know that we provide electricity to the product, and then we get the masala mix as the outcome of the product. So, we have a masala mix coming as outcome, and then we provide electricity as input. So, input and output. Now, what is happening in between this input and output are the basic functions of the product. So, whatever happens inside is the function or they are the functions of the product. So, we start asking questions, how do we make masala mix? So, how do we get masala mix? By chopping, grinding, right? So, you chop, squash or grind grains, you will get masala mix. So, how do we chop them? You need to rotate the blades or the blades of the grinder. You need to rotate them inside. So, you will get you will be able to chop. How do we rotate? You convert electricity to torque. So, you will be able to convert electricity to torque and rotate the blades. And how do you convert? You supply the power to the system. And how do you supply power? You provide the electricity. So, we have reached the other end of the boundary. So, we have two boundaries. So, started from one boundary and when reached the other boundary, so we stopped there. So, this is known as the critical path function or the primary functions. Now, when we do this critical path function or when we try to get this critical path function, there will be many sub functions which are needed in order to do this critical path function. For example, chop, squash, grinding grains, you need to First of all, seal for grinding, because you cannot keep it open. That the items or the material need to be sealed. So that is one requirement. And then you need to have something which can actually hold the grain. That is basically contain grains. And then there should be something called accept grains, because you need to have opening and closing of it so that you can add grain and then remove grain. That is basically accept grain. So there should be functions which actually allow us to accept grain, contain grain and seal for grinding. So these three functions are needed in order to do this function. So now you look at that from a point of view of, suppose you want to grind something, you cannot do it in the air. So you need something to contain the grain, you need to something to close the grain, the container, and as well as you should be able to remove it and close it and open it. That is the requirement of accept grains. So these three functions are needed in order to chop or squash or grind grains. And now rotate blades. So rotate blades is a function which is needed in order to chop the grains. But then we need to do this, we need to transmit the torque. Similarly, when you transmit torque, there will be vibration. So generate noise and vibration will be the unwanted function. So dampen vibration, because whenever you try to transmit torque, there may be vibrations. So you dampen vibration. Generate noise is an unwanted function. So this is an unwanted function. So you need to add a function to reduce the noise. That becomes another function. So these are the sub functions that you can identify when you are rotating blades. Not necessary. Okay. So this one not necessary that you need to follow how and why. How and why is mainly for the critical path function. Now by looking at the critical path function, so there actually you can actually add some more also. For example, hold blade. Okay. Now suppose you are thinking of something where actually you can replace the blade, then you need to have accept blade, because you are able to change blade. So accept blade or hold blade. So these are actually additional functions you can think of here. So these are the, I mean, that is the way how you try to get the sub functions from the main critical path function. Okay. Supply actual power, you connect electricity. That is basically you are telling you need to have something to take electricity from the main socket to the equipment. So that is basically connect electricity. Now, this actually shows the decomposition of the function. Now, if you look at this each one, you will see that there will be a product, there will be a part which actually do this job. In any product, every product when you design, you need to look at, okay, which part of the product is going to do this task. So that is basically how you convert this into the physical structure. But by looking at this, you will be able to identify all the functions, and that actually is the functional decomposition of this product. So this is the way how we do the decomposition using FAST method. So what does FAST stand for? Function analysis system technique. So function analysis system techniques allows you to identify all the sub functions in the product, and then you can actually design products based on these functions. Now you can design a better method to reduce noise. You can think of how to reduce noise can be added as a new concept, can be added to reduce noise. Or you want to dampen vibration, you can think of a new method to dampen vibration. Or sealing of grinding can have a different method. So by looking at these functions, you can identify how the product can be improved or can be made as a innovative one compared to the existing product. So that is the need why we need to do the functional decomposition of the product. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So we'll take an example of a pump. I think most of you have done the pump as an lab experiment. Okay. So if you take the pump as an product, you will see that, okay, so we can actually have two lines. So let me identify these two lines. Okay. So what will be the function here and here? What is an assumed function for the pump? Pumping water is the output, right? So you can say pump water or you can just pump water, assuming that basically you want to increase the head of the water, right? From a lower head to a higher head, you want to track. That is basically the function of the pump. And so this is the overall function or output. So that is the overall function. And what is the input we assume here? Electricity. Assume that it's an electrically powered pump. So provide electricity is the. Now we need to ask the question, how and why. So in electrical pump, we need to ask how to pump water. So how do you answer this question? How do you pump water? Pardon? So how will you do that? What will be the first primary function? So basically we are trying to find out the critical path function, which actually provides or converts this electricity to pumping water. Okay. So pumping water is basically you increase the head of the water. You pump take water from a lower head to a higher head. So you can say basically, you can say rotating the impeller, right? So you rotate the impeller to increase its energy so that you can actually pump it, right? So probably you can say it is rotate the impeller. And how do you rotate the impeller? You provide torque. And how do you provide torque? You convert electrical energy to torque. And how do you do this? You supply power, right? So supply power. So that is the way you can find out this. Now this is the, this thing will actually give you more important functions in the. So if you want to rotate the impeller, there are many things. Now one should be, you need to hold the impeller, you need to, not only just by rotating impeller you don't get power, so you need to, water, you need to accept water. So water should be accepted into the pump, then water should be taken out of the pump, and then impeller need to be held in a particular orientation, and then it has to be rotated. So all those become the sub functions over here. Similarly, provide torque, as you saw that it will be there will be something like transmit torque, and you will be having functions here. So these are the sub functions that you can identify what are needed in a product. And what will be an unwanted function here? Yeah, maybe noise, yeah, or sometimes vibration, yeah. So noise and vibration. Okay. Sometimes other function may be leakage. Leakage may be coming here as an unwanted function, right? Because water may leak, so you need to reduce the leakage, may become an additional function. So leakage becomes an unwanted function, so you need to add another function which will reduce leakage. So vibration is an unwanted function, noise is an unwanted function, leakage is an unwanted function. So now we need to find a function to reduce leakage, reduce noise, and reduce vibration. That becomes additional functions. So this way, by looking at this, you will be able to identify the all those sub functions in a product. And then as a designer, you can see, find out which function you want to improve in order to improve the product, or in order to make the product better than the existing product. So that is the way how we look at the design of this the functional decomposition of the product. And this side also you can say why to provide electricity, because you want to provide supply power to the product. Why are you supplying power? Because you want to convert that into torque. Why are you doing converting torque? Because you want to provide torque to the system. And why are you providing? Because you want to rotate the impeller. And why are you rotating the impeller? Because you want to pump the water. So this way you'll be able to answer why and how in both cases, and you will be able to get the functions identified, the critical path functions, and then all the functions which are coming as a result of the critical path function will become the other secondary functions in the product. Okay. So, if you look at this, okay, so pump water, rotate impeller, convert electricity to torque, supply actual power, connect electricity. So these are the critical path functions you can identify. And by these functions, you can pump water, you can identify some sub functions, and accept water, hold water, allow water to move. So these are the sub functions that you can identify in this case. Yeah. Aesthetic design is an all-time function. So, you won't be able to identify a function corresponding to this in the decomposition. So, that basically this is an all-time function that you, the product, whenever you design the product. No one? Yeah, it's a more of a creative thing. So, in the functional decomposition, you won't be able to get the aesthetic design as a function. So, that, but what actually it says that whenever you design any of these elements, that should have this component of aesthetics into built into it. That's what actually it says that, okay, aesthetics is an important requirement in this product. And whenever you design the any, because these are the functions, suppose there is a transmit torque, you are designing a transition element. And it should not like projecting out of the product. It should actually feel that it is, I mean, it should look like it's a very nice design. So, the aesthetics should be brought into the design of when you develop a new concept for this particular function, make sure that it is aesthetically appealing. That's what actually it says. This by it's an all-time function. Oh, no, not that way. See, electricity is considered as an input, okay. Yeah, it's not a function of the product per se. So, providing electricity is not a function of product. Yeah, product assumes that electricity is there, okay. That is why it is not given outside this the scope of the product. These two lines are the within the scope of the product. So, providing electricity is outside the scope of product. So, we assume that electricity is there. If electricity is there, what is the product should do? So, that is basically known as the functions of the product. And aesthetic design is considered as an all-time function because think that, okay, whatever may be the situation, the aesthetics of the product should be maintained. Okay, that is what actually it says, right? Bigger size of? No. See, compact system says that it's a one-time function. See, why it has to be compact? Because this has to be transported from a manufacturer to supplier, I mean, to the salesperson to the home. Okay. So, only during that stage only it has to be compact. Otherwise, once you install it, people don't really worry about it's slightly bigger or smaller. It's not a big issue. So, you make the compact system compact. So, that this is a one-time function. So, once you made that one, then no need to change anything with that. So, it's only not a continuous requirement of the product. No, bigger actually. No, if you are looking for the design which is bigger or you want to make it, then this will not be a function provided in the product. So, in this particular case, we are assuming that it has to be compact. Okay, but when you are looking for a bigger, then that will come under the capacity and the specifications itself. When you design the, when you develop the product specification, there actually we will say what is the maximum size, maximum weight, that will be there in the specification itself. Okay, so that comes from there itself in the specification. So, here as a function, what is to be needed is given in the compact or as a one-time function for the product. Reduce leakage is a objective of the design process. Okay, so we need to identify the function which actually leads to leakages, and then how to, so have some one function which reduce leakage. So we need to develop new concepts for this reduce leakage function and then make it as satisfy this condition. So that is where how it is done. One time, okay, see that if it is compactness is a requirement throughout its lifetime, I mean it is a continuously transported, for example a mobile phone, we carry it all the time, right? So compactness becomes an all-time function requirement. Yeah, but in this case pump is not going to be carried by somebody. Once you install it, then there is no need. That's why in the first, only one time you need to make sure that it is compact for the purpose of transport and other things. Otherwise, it's not a requirement. One time and? One time does not mean that only once in its lifetime. I'm saying that it's not a continuous requirement. Only some particular instances only that may be needed. So you don't need to make it as a all time function, you just make it as a one time function and then solve it. Pardon? It can be more than one time function also. Okay, so that actually we can add here. If you have more than one time function, you can add it here. Okay, so this is not, again as I told you, it need not be a unique one. When I develop something, I have my own way of designing what is one time, what is all time. But someone else designed, they may think, okay, oh, probably I need to add another one time function. So he may add another one time function also. So this way you will be having different, it need not be a unique way of identifying. But the most important part is that you should be able to identify all the functions needed within the product, so that you will be able to develop concepts for these functions to make it a new product. That is the idea here. Okay. Sort of doing a class exercise, let us keep this for some other class. Okay, I'll give one more example to see how to do the how to get the fast decomposition. For example, this is for a LED light development. Assume that you are trying to develop a LED or some other light. Okay, it need not be LED. So an electrical lighting system. So we assume that provide current or provide electricity is the assumed function, and then illuminate a region is the overall function of the product or the output of the product. So how do we illuminate the region? You could question this, how to illuminate. Then you will say that, okay, you emit light. And how do you emit light? You convert energy, electrical energy. So how do you convert? You conduct the current and receive current and provide current here. And generate heat is an unwanted function. So minimize heat becomes a required function. And disperse light becomes another requirement here. When you conduct current, you will be having a light generation. So that need to be dispersed, and then emit light. So you can see that convert energy. So how do you convert energy is a question. And what happens when you convert energy? You generate heat. So that heat has to be dissipated or minimize the heat generation. This becomes the thing. Okay. And other functions like, do you need to mount the bulb and attract the user? These are the functions, additional functions you can think. Then resist corrosion, prevent short circuit, and resist breakage. This becomes the all time functions needed in the product. Yeah. Any question? Yeah. Okay. So these are the ways how you can actually convert this by asking the questions how and why. So any product you take, you should be able to identify this critical path function, and then corresponding to the critical path, you will be able to get the function. So this is a simple form of functional decomposition. It can be used for simple product. So that is one important thing. because a product which has got only a single critical function or single critical path, then we can use this fast methods. But suppose some products are having multiple functions, then you won't be able to do this in a fast method, because it's not only one critical path, there may be multiple critical paths coming, then it becomes very complex. So the user won't be able to develop functional decomposition using fast method, and therefore we go for something called a, okay, so before I go to that one, I think this I explained in one of the classes. So what we do finally with these functions is basically to create this as a function tree. So we'll have that top level function, the basic function at the top level, and then we identify the sub functions at the secondary level, or this becomes the critical path functions, and then for each critical path function you will be able to identify sub functions, and then even for that you may be able to get additional assumed functions or assumed function. So from the fast method or any other function decomposition method, you will be able to identify all these functions, and then based on this we'll create something called a function tree. And in one of the, I mean, our lab exercises, we used to create the product structure, right? You assembly structure you used to have. So this will be the top level product. Then you will identify all the sub assemblies here, and then the components here. It is the same way. The product will be writing it as the function, and then the sub functions, and then the sub functions, and you will be getting it as a function tree for the product. So the function tree is basically a hierarchical assembly of the functions in a product, and at the lowest level you will see all the small sub functions which need not be decomposed further, or you will be able to identify a product or a part which actually provides these sub functions. For example, convert electricity to torque or mechanical energy, that's a function, right? And we know that there is a product or there is a motor which actually do this. So you don't need to really decompose it further, saying that, okay, you provide current, fast current to create magnetic flux. You don't need to write that one. You can just stop it, convert electrical energy to torque. So this is the way how we write down the function. When we reach that level, then we don't decompose it further. So you'll be getting it as a product, as a motor. So the purpose of doing a functional decomposition is to basically to create a function tree for the product. So you should be able to generate a function tree which identify all the sub functions needed within the product in order to get the top level function of the product. Okay. Yeah. So give some examples for the function tree. This is basically for a electrical screwdriver. So if I use the electrical screwdriver and try to develop the function tree for this, then you will be able to write down the sub functions as, so loosen or tighten screws is the top level function of a screwdriver, right? Now what are the sub functions needed? We need to supply power, that is one function. It should be able to work manually also, and then use different bits needed, apply torque and feel comfortable. So these are the functions that you can identify from for a screwdriver. So this feel comfortable is more from the user friendliness requirement of the customer. Now for each one of these, you will be able to identify the sub functions, where actually we can say use electricity, generate torque, convert electricity to torque. So we stop here, we don't need to do further, and supply electricity, actuate electricity and regulate electricity. So what does this mean? Why do we have these functions coming here? Actuate electricity, regulate electricity. So it's an electrical screwdriver. So we assume it is an electrical screwdriver. So from where these functions are coming? Any idea? Yeah. So one is that, see, actuate electricity means you need to switch on or off, right? So we have to on or off the system. That is, that can be done only through a actuate electricity. That is, you are actuating or not actuating. That is basically actuate electricity. Basically, you are telling there should be a a function to stop or start the drilling process. The regulated electricity basically tells that you should be able to control the speed or the torque, right? Because there should be some facility in the system in order to increase the speed or increase the torque or decrease the speed or decrease the torque. That is basically known as regulated electricity. Okay, so every electrical product normally will be having, if you take the fan, fan also has got a switch and a regulator, right? So the switch is basically to on or off. That is the function which we say actuate electricity. And regulate electricity is basically you want to control the speed of the fan. So that is the regulation here. So these two functions are important for most of the electrical products. So if you take the any electrical product, you will be able to find that this becomes a very common functional module in the product. Most of the electrical products will be having this because it has to convert electricity to torque. And not only that, it has to actuate electricity and it has to regulate electricity also. So without this, most of the electrical products won't work. If you assume that there is no need to control the speed, then you don't need to have regulated electricity. But whenever there is a need to control the speed or torque or the output, then there will be something called regulated electricity. And again, as I told you, we always use a noun and a verb to represent the function. So you can see we are using supply electricity, actuate electricity, regulate electricity as a noun and verb. So that is the first part of electrical module. So this becomes the electrical sub function of the product. So you can see from the main function we identify a sub function of power module, and here you will see the all the functions needed. So we don't do it beyond this decomposition because we assume that once you say actual electricity, you can use a switch. Regulated electricity, you can use a regulator or a speed control. That is what actually we assume here. Now, there is a requirement for this to work manually. Without electricity, you should be able to work. Then you need to hold this support rotation, withstand torque, position device. That is work manually. Okay, not without electricity. Sorry, this is somebody has to hold the equipment and use it. That is what work manually with the tool. So we need to support the rotation because rotation torque will be there just to withstand the torque, and we should be able to position the device in the required direction or in the required orientation. So that is the sub function secure rotation, allow rotation degree of freedom, dissipate torque, regulate rotation, regulate translation. So you should be able to regulate the in-out movement as well as the orientation of the tool manually. That's why you should have this kind of functions needed in the or provided in the product. That is the requirement for to make it manually operational. And the next one is to use different bits, tool bits. You should be able to use different tool bits depending on the type of screws or the type of the nuts and bolts you want to use. Then you should be able to change the bit and hold the bit. That is, accept bit is basically telling that you should be able to take new bit or remove the old bit and hold the bit here. So two functions, accept bit and hold bit. And in accept bit, we say it is coupled solid, separate solids. Coupled solid means you should be able to couple one solid to another solid. That is the new tool to be added. Separate solid, you should be able to remove the solid also, remove the tool bit. And secure solid is basically should be secured so that it will not come out of it. So these are the functions needed in order to use different tools. So if you are planning to use different tools, there should be a function to couple the tool, function to remove the tool, and a function to secure the tool also. These three functions needed in order to get this one done. So that is what actually says. So if you want to do get this done, then we have 1, 2, 3, 4 functions. And if you want to do this, you need to have these three sub functions. Similarly, apply torque, transmit torque, rotate screw, withstand forces. And each one you can see change torque is direction of change. Change of direction of torque can be changed. Transmit torque, the transmitted torque to be transmitted. Then you should be able to rotate the solid for the screw to be unscrewed or screwed. And dissipate torque, that is the vibration and all should be controlled. That is the these are the lower level functions you can identify for this particular function. So feel comfortable is again more of an aesthetics and ergonomics part. So feel comfortable is that we are actually holding the tool. So we are using our hand to hold the tool. So we are actually importing the hand to the product, and we are importing the human force to the product. So these are the two things that you will be doing when we are doing using the product. So this, how do we make this one more and more comfortable? That makes this feel comfortable. So feel comfortable, these two functions need to be understood. How do we put our hand onto the product to hold it? And similarly, how do we apply a human force into the products in order to loosen or tighten the screws? So these are the two functions that will affect the comfortable holding of the product by the user. So that is, these are the two functions. Now we can see that we decompose this main function into four critical path functions. And then each one of these were actually decomposed into small functions. And finally, we could actually bring out a functional function tree for the electrical screwdriver. So this is what we do when we are developing a function tree for any product. Okay, so assume that what we need to do, we have an electrical screwdriver. You want to loosen or tighten screws using electrical screwdriver, right? So one thing what we need is that you need to have electrical torque generated, okay, or you should have some kind of called electrical module which provides you torque for the operation, okay. The second one is you want to use it as a manual tool. It's not a machine tool where actually man will not be touching it. They're actually using a man is holding it and then using it, right? That is what actually you should be able to work manually with the products. That is one another function needed. And another function is that you should be able to use different bits for different applications, okay. And then you need to apply a torque for moving it in or out, okay. And of course, it should be feel comfortable also. So when you provide these five functions, then only it can actually do the required job of loosening or tightening of screws. Got it? So that is why we need to have these five functions in order to get this top level function. Now we look into this, each one of these, and then see what are the things needed in this one in order to get this particular part done. So that we see that actuation of electricity, regulate electricity and convert electricity to torque are the three functions needed in this module to provide the necessary torque. Same way, we look into each one of these and then try to decompose it and then find out the lowest level function. That is what we do in the function tree generation. Okay. Yeah. So we'll stop here and discuss this in the next class, and then we'll go to another method which can be used for any complex products. For example, if you take a refrigerator or any other for an automobile car or something like that, there can be many critical path functions. So we won't be able to do it as a fast method or simple method. So we go for something complex where we look at the material, energy and force interactions, and then try to find out how to do the decomposition of the product. Okay, so we'll stop here and then continue in the next class.